An antenna array is a set of multiple connected antennas which work together as a single antenna to transmit or receive radio waves. The resultant pattern of an array depends upon number of antennas used in the array, shape of the array, the individual patterns of each source, distance between the antennas, power magnitude for each antenna, phase difference with respect to power field, array dimensions, etc. The radio waves radiated by each individual antenna combine and superpose, adding together to enhance the power radiated in desired directions and cancelling to reduce the power radiated in other directions. Similarly, when used for receiving, the separate radio frequency currents from the individual antennas combine in the receiver with the correct phase relationship to enhance signals received from the desired directions and cancel signals from undesired directions. An antenna array can achieve higher gain, that is, a narrower beam of radio waves, than could be achieved by a single element. In general, the larger number of individual antenna elements used, the higher the gain and the narrower the beam. Antenna arrays can be used to achieve higher gain, to give path diversity, which increases communication reliability, to cancel interference from specific directions, etc. Arrays of two isotropic point sources. The first case we shall analyze is that of two isotropic point sources having equal amplitudes and oscillating in the same phase. Let the two point sources 1 and 2 be separated by a distance d and located symmetrically with respect to the origin of the coordinates. The angle phi is measured counterclockwise from the positive x-axis. The origin of the coordinates is taken as the reference for phase. The total path difference is d by 2 cos phi plus d by 2 cos phi. At a distance point in the direction of phi, the field from source 1 is retarded by d by 2 cos phi, while the field from source 2 is advanced by d by 2 cos phi, which is equal to d cos phi. Therefore, total path difference is d by lambda cos phi wavelengths. Total phase angle xi is equal to 2 pi into path difference which is equal to 2 pi path difference is d by lambda cos phi, which is equal to dr cos phi is equal to phase angle. Where dr is 2 pi d by lambda, which is equal to beta d in radians. Now total field E is equal to E1 e to the power j xi by 2 plus E2 e to the power minus j xi by 2. E is the total field at a distant point. E1 is amplitude of source 1 and E2 is amplitude of source 2. Figure shows the vector addition of the fields from two isotropic point sources of equal amplitude and same phase. Here, source 1 and 2 are placed symmetrically with respect to the origin. The total phase angle is divided into equals half, with source 1 having lagging exponential factor and source 2 having leading exponential factor. And we know that isotropic point sources are having a same amplitude, therefore we can consider as E1 equal to E2 equal to E0. Therefore total field is equal to E0 e to the power j xi by 2 plus e to the power minus j xi by 2, which is equal to E is equal to 2 E naught cos xi by 2. In order to normalize In order to normalize the pattern, amplitude 2E0 is equal to 1. Therefore, normalized total field is equal to cos xi by 2, which is equal to 2E0 cos, what is xi? Xi is dr cos phi by 2. So to normalize the pattern, we have to equate 2E0 equal to 1. Therefore, normalized field is equal to cos dr cos phi by 2. We know that dr is equal to 2 pi d by lambda, and substitute dr into the E normalized equation. And also substitute D is equal to lambda by 2. Therefore, cos 2 pi lambda by 2 cos phi divided by 2. Normalized field is equal to cos of pi by 2 cos phi. In order to plot the relative field pattern, we need to know maxima, minima and half power points. To find out maxima direction, equate plus or minus 1 to the E normalized equation when D equal to lambda by 2, that is cos of pi by 2 cos phi plus or minus 1. Therefore, pi by 2 cos phi maximum is equal to cos inverse of plus or minus 1, which is equal to plus or minus 2 cos maximum phi value is equal to plus or minus k pi. When k equal to, if k equal to 0, phi maximum equal to plus or minus 90 degree. For minima direction, E normalization is equal to 0, that is cos of pi by 2 cos phi when D equal to lambda by 2 for the case when two isotropic point sources having same amplitude and same phase. Pi by 2 cos phi minimum phi is equal to plus or minus 2k plus 1 pi by 2. We have to generalize the cos inverse of 0, we have to generalize the values. Now phi minimum, cos of phi minimum is equal to plus or minus 2k plus 1. If k equal to 0, cos phi minimum is equal to plus or minus 1. Therefore, phi minimum is equal to cos inverse of plus or minus 1, which is equal to 0 degree or 180 degree. To find out the half power points, cos of pi by 2 cos phi, that is the E normalized equation, should be equated with the plus or minus 1 by root 2. Pi by 2 cos phi is equal to cos inverse of plus or minus 1 by root 2, which is equal to plus or minus 2k plus 1 pi by 4. Therefore, cos phi half power point direction is equal to plus or minus 2k plus 1 divided by 2. Therefore, phi HP is equal to cos inverse of plus or minus 2k plus 1 divided by 2. If k equal to 0, phi hp is equal to plus or minus 60 degree or plus or minus 120 degree. Therefore, normalized field for two isotropic point sources of same amplitude and phase at d equal to lambda by 2 is cos of pi by 2 cos phi. And maxima direction is plus or minus 90 degree. Minima directions are 0 degree and 180 degree. Half power point directions are plus or minus 60 degree and plus or minus 120 degree. When you plot relative field pattern for the case 1, that is two isotropic point sources having the same amplitude and phase, we get the field pattern is in this where plus 90 degree minus 90 degree shows the maxima direction. Minima direction 0 degree and 180 degree. Half power point direction 60 degree, minus 60 degree, and plus 120 degree, minus 120 degree. This is a field pattern for two isotropic point sources of same amplitude and phase are symmetrically located symmetrically with respect to the origin of the coordinates. The field pattern for two point sources of same amplitude and phase can be obtained by locating source 1 at the origin of the coordinates and source 2 at the distance d along the positive x-axis as indicated in figure. Therefore, phase angle xi equal to dr cos phi, where dr is equal to 2 pi d by lambda, which is equal to beta d. The field from source 1 as reference, the field from source 2 in the direction phi is advanced by dr cos phi. Thus, total field intensity E at a large distance r is the vector sum of the fields from the two sources is given by E1 e to the power j0. Since source 1 is at origin, E2 e to the power j xi from the origin to the source 2. Since two point sources of same amplitude we are using here, E1 equal to E2 equal to E0. Therefore, total field E is equal to E0 e to the power j0 plus E0 e to the power j xi. Total field E equal to E0 1 plus e to the power j xi, which is equal to 2 E0 e to the power j xi by 2 e to the power j minus j xi by 2 plus e to the power j xi by 2 divided by 2. Therefore, total field is equal to 2 E0 e to the power j xi by 2 cos xi by 2. to normalize the pattern. Amplitude is made equal to unity, that is 2E not equal to 1. Therefore, normalized field is equal to e to the power j xi by 2 cos xi by 2. Therefore, E normalized field is equal to cos xi by 2 angle xi by 2. Cosine factor gives amplitude variation of field E, and exponential or angle factor gives phase variation with respect to source 1 as a reference. Two isotropic point sources of same amplitude but opposite phase. To analyze the field pattern for the case 2, that is two isotropic point sources of same amplitude but opposite phase, we'll consider two isotropic point sources which is symmetrically placed with respect to origin of coordinate at a distance d. Their amplitudes are equal and phases are opposite to each other. Therefore, minus E1 equal to E2. The phase are opposite means when source 1 reaches maximum, then source 2 is at its minimum. Therefore, path difference is equal to d by 2 cos phi plus d by 2 cos phi, which is equal to d cos phi in wavelengths divided by lambda. Therefore, phase angle xi equal to 2 pi into path difference is equal to 2 pi d by lambda cos phi. Therefore, phase angle is equal to dr cos phi radians. Where dr is equal to 2 pi d by lambda, which is equal to beta d. Total field intensity is given by E equal to minus E1 e to the power minus j xi by 2 plus E2 e to the power j xi by 2. Two sources having equal amplitudes, therefore E1 equal to E2 equal to E0, but are in opposite phase, that's why E equal to minus E1 e to the power minus j xi by 2 plus E2 e to the power j xi by 2. Therefore, total field intensity is E0 minus e to the power minus j xi by 2 plus e to the power j xi by 2, which is equal to total field is equal to 2 E0 j sin xi by 2. To normalize the pattern, we can made amplitude is equal to 1, that is 2E naught J equal to 1. Therefore, normalized field intensity is equal to sine xi by 2. Let D equal to lambda by 2, then xi equal to dr cos phi, so xi equal to 2 pi d by lambda cos phi, therefore 2 pi d is lambda by 2 divided by lambda cos phi, which is equal to pi cos phi. Hence, therefore, normalized field is equal to sine of pi by 2 cos phi. To plot the relative field pattern, we have to find maxima, minima, and half power points. To find the maxima direction, E normalized equation, that is sine of pi by 2 cos phi, maximum value is equate with plus or minus 1. Pi by 2 cos phi is equal to sine inverse of plus or minus 1, which is equal to plus or minus 2k plus 1 pi by 2. Let k equal to 0, pi by 2 cos phi is equal to plus or minus pi by 2. Therefore, phi maximum value is 0 degree and 180 degree. To find out minima direction, sine pi by 2 cos phi is equal to 0. Therefore, pi by 2 cos phi is equal to sine inverse of 0, which is equal to plus or minus k pi. If k equal to 0, pi is equal to plus or minus 90 degree. For half power point directions, sine pi by 2 cos phi is equal to plus or minus 1 by root 2. Pi by 2 cos phi is sine inverse of plus or minus 1 by root 2. Pi by 2 cos phi is equal to plus or minus 2k plus 1 pi by 4. If k equal to 0, pi by 2 cos phi is equal to plus or minus pi by 4. Phi is equal to cos inverse of plus or minus half. Therefore, half point directions are plus or minus 60 degree and plus or minus 120 degree. When the two isotropic sources are arranged on the same axis and sources having the same amplitude and opposite directions, then we got maxima directions at 0 degree and 180 degree, minima directions at plus or minus 90 degree, and half power point directions are plus or minus 60 degree and plus or minus 120 degree. These directions, when we draw in the coordinates, we will get the pattern like this. Maxima at 0 degree and 180 degree. Minima plus 90 degree, minus 90 degree directions. And HP plus 60 degree, half power point directions are at 60 degree, minus 60 degree, 120 degree, minus 120 degree. This is the field pattern for the case when two isotropic forces point sources having same amplitude and different phase, opposite phase, lying on the same axis and located symmetrically with respect to the origin for d equal to lambda by 2. Case 3. Two isotropic point sources of the same amplitude and in phase quadrature. Consider two isotropic point sources be located as shown in figure. As they have the same amplitudes, we can say that E1 equal to E2 equal to E0. They are in phase quadrature means source 1 is retarded by 45 degree and source 2 is advanced by 45 degree. The path difference is d by 2 cos phi plus d by 2 cos phi. Therefore, path difference is d cos phi divided by lambda wavelength. Phase angle xi is equal to 2 pi into path difference, which is equal to 2 pi. Path difference is d cos phi by lambda. Therefore, phase angle is equal to dr cos phi by lambda. Total field is given by E equal to E1 e to power minus j xi by 2 e to power minus j pi by 4 plus E2 e to power j xi by 2 e to power j pi by 4. So, E1 is the amplitude of the source 1, E2 is the amplitude of source 2. Both the sources are in phase quadrature means source 1 is retarded by pi by 4 and source 2 is advanced by pi by 4. Therefore, we have written the field intensity as this expression continuing, E1 equal to E2 equal to E0 since both are having the same amplitude. E to the power minus j xi by 2 plus pi by 4 plus e to the power j xi by 2 plus pi by 4. Therefore, E is equal to E naught into e to the power minus j xi by 2 plus pi by 4 plus e to the power j xi by 2 plus pi by 4 divided by 2. Therefore, I'll multiply it with the 2. So now this is in the form 2 e naught cos xi by 2 plus pi by 4. This is a total field. So in order to normalize the field, E equal to, in order to normalize the field, we have to equate maximum value to E naught is equal to 1. Therefore, E normalized equation is cos of xi by 2 plus pi by 4. Let D equal to lambda by 2, then xi is equal to dr cos phi, dr is equal to 2 pi d by lambda. When I substitute 2 pi lambda by 2 divided by lambda, the dr is equal to pi. Therefore, xi is equal to pi cos phi. Then I can substitute xi value into the E normalized equation, then cos pi cos phi divided by 2 plus pi by 4. This is the E normalized equation. To draw the field pattern, we need to know maxima, minima and half power point directions. To find out the maxima direction, E normalized equation cos of pi by 2 cos phi plus pi by 4 should be equate with plus or minus 1. So pi by 2 cos phi plus pi by 4 is equal to cos inverse of plus or minus 1. Pi by 2 cos phi plus pi by 4 is equal to plus or minus k pi. If k equal to 0, pi by 2 cos phi is equal to minus pi by 4. So cos phi equal to minus half. Therefore, phi equal to cos inverse of minus half, which is equal to plus or minus 120 degree. To find out minima direction, cos pi by 2 cos phi plus pi by 4 is equal to 0. Pi by 2 cos phi plus pi by 4 is equal to plus or minus 2k plus 1 pi by 2. If k equal to 0, pi by 2 cos phi plus pi by 4 is equal to plus or minus pi by 2. Pi by 2 cos phi is equal to plus or minus pi by 4. So phi is equal to cos phi is equal to plus or minus half. Therefore, phi is equal to plus or minus 60 degrees. Half power point direction. Cos of pi by 2 cos phi plus pi by 4 is equal to plus or minus 1 by root 2. So pi by 2 cos of phi plus pi by 4 is equal to cos inverse plus or minus 1 by root 2. Pi by 2 cos phi plus pi by 4 is equal to plus or minus 2k plus 1 pi by 4. So pi by 2, if k equal to 0, pi by 2 cos phi plus pi by 4 is equal to pi by plus or minus pi by 4. So pi by 2 cos phi is equal to plus or minus pi by 4 minus pi by 4 is equal to 0. Therefore phi is equal to plus or minus 90 degrees. Figure shows the relative field pattern of two isotropic point sources of the same amplitude and in phase quadrature for a spacing of lambda by 2. The source to the right leads that to the left by 90 degrees. It is a cardioid shaped unidirection pattern with maximum field in the negative x direction. Case 4. Two isotropic point sources with same amplitude and any phase difference. When two isotropic sources are placed symmetrically with respect to the origin so that they are separated by distance d and have any phase difference, then phase angle is xi is equal to beta d cos phi plus delta. Then total electric field E is equal to amplitude of source 1, phase at source 1, amplitude of source 2, phase at source 2. When two isotropic point sources having same amplitude, then E1 equal to E2 equal to E0. Therefore, total field is E0 e to the power minus j psi by 2 plus e to the power j psi by 2. Therefore, total field E is equal to 2E naught e to the power minus j xi by 2 plus e to the power j xi by 2 divided by 2. So E is equal to 2E naught cos xi by 2. To normalize, is the field equate 2E naught is equal to 1, then field is equal to cos xi by 2. For general case, when two isotropic sources with same amplitude and any phase difference, the normalized field is equal to cos of xi by 2, as xi is phase angle, which is dr cos phi plus delta, where dr is 2 pi d by lambda and delta is phase difference. Case 5. Most general case of two isotropic point sources of unequal amplitude and any phase difference. Let source 1 be placed at the origin of coordinate system, as the array has a phase difference of delta. Then phase angle xi is equal to beta d cos phi plus delta. The source have unequal amplitude. Let source 1 be amplitude of source 1 E naught, amplitude of source 2 be A E naught. If source 1 is taken as reference for the phase, total electric field intensity is measured at a distant point in the direction of phi is given by E equal to E naught. Source 1 is at origins, therefore 0, plus A E naught, amplitude of the source 2, e to the power j xi. Therefore, E equal to E naught 1 plus A E naught. Sorry, 1 plus A e to the power j xi. Therefore, total field intensity is equal to E naught 1 plus A e to the power j xi is equal to cos xi plus j sin xi. The absolute value is given by E naught root of 1 plus A cos xi square plus A sin xi square to angle zeta. by vector addition from the following figure, amplitude of the source 1 is greater than amplitude of source 2. Source 2 is smaller than source 1 by the factor A. Therefore, from the figure we can write tan zeta is equal to AE naught sine xi divided by E naught plus AE naught cos xi. So which is equal to A sin xi divided by 1 plus A cos xi. So the phase is equal to tan inverse of A sin xi divided by 1 plus A cos xi. We know that this length is AE naught cos xi and this AE naught sin xi. Therefore, we could write the zeta value.